Alrighty, hello there. Here we are on Sunday evening, November 3rd, 2019 at 6:03 p.m. And we might start off with a few pictures, but I'm out here playing again. At the moment, I'm on the Canon R full-frame camera. And this time I have the older Tamron 18-400 millimeter lens on here. And I forgot to do something. There we go, I wanted to get situated. I had it on a 1080p 60 and I wanted to change it to 4K. And poor Jupiter's heading down into that chimney. I was kind of surprised to get it at all. Oh, you know what? So, it's too late for that. Let's try to head over to Saturn instead. There we go. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I do believe the bottom left one should be Saturn. It's so hard to tell when you can't zoom in further to make sure you got the rings, so. And there we go with the wider view. We can see a few stars, two planets, and a 46% moon. 45 or 46, I'm not sure. And there we go. And that's not another planet. Over top of the moon, I see a flare and reflections from the camera. It's a cool look though. We have a bit of earth shine. Yeah, so you can see I can move that planet around. So you can tell it's a camera artifact. Anyway, let's try to get the moon in better. Okay, it's as far as I can zoom. Darn it. Alright, there we go, I think. We have it in focus. And if I'm not mistaken, I do believe the moon's in Capricorn, while Saturn, of course, is still in Sagittarius. I think all last year, now this year, Saturn's over been by Sagittarius, and now next year, if I'm not mistaken, I believe Jupiter and Saturn will be closer together in their orbit. They won't be as far apart. Now in 2018 they were further apart than they were this year. And if what I looked at was right on this Sky Safari Pro app, it looked like they'll be even closer next year, so that'll be cool. Anyway, there's not much there we can see. So there we have the moon and Saturn in the same shot with our willow tree. Let's try to go faster here. There we go. And we can still see Jupiter heading down for the night. It's in the bottom right, over to the right of that chimney. And we see a airplane. Lights blinking right below it. That's quite cool. All right, it's quite nippy out here. It's about 37 degrees or so. Nearly freezing. So we'll check our settings one more time. Okay. And you shouldn't have the shutter speed low like I have it, but I do it to brighten up the dark sky. If there's no movement, it's not too bad. But anyway, we're recording this onto the Atomos Ninja Flame tonight. And we should be on 4K now. With that Tamron 18 to 400 millimeter lens on the Canon R camera. As we play around, I wouldn't mind putting the Kenko teleconverters on here, but my fingers are frozen already, so. And I was gonna go back in and get the other camera. Maybe I still will, we'll see. I wouldn't mind so much if it was summertime and much warmer and more pleasant out, but, and I know folks love to see how far that P1000 can zoom in. It is quite cool, but I have a hard time motivating myself when it's so cold out to drag more gear out. We shall see though. Now what the heck, I'll let that run and go grab the other camera. I'll be right back. Alrighty, here we go. Finally, I think I'm all situated. So we have both cameras running. The Canon's getting the wide angle view. And we have our Nikon P1000. So it's good to see Saturn again. My gosh. Been well over a week, I think, since we last got the planets, and now this is about the only one I'll be able to get now for quite a while. Jupiter's already gone. It's tucked tail behind that tree and house and chimney and everything else. And with all the obstructions in the way, I can't get Venus after the sun sets because of all the trees and such. Other folks can see it, but I can't from my location. Anyway, it's cool to see Saturn again. But of course, while we're here, we'd like to get a good look at the moon. It's been too long. There we are. Let's go further in to make sure we have it in focus before we do much anything else. I do believe we have it. All right, that's not the best view of the moon, but it looks like it's going to be the best we can get. So let's take a ride around, see what's up here. And we are at the max zoom this P1000 can do. And take a jaunt down the right side. See if anything zips by. Let's darken that up first. There we go. Now it's still a bit bright there, but oh well. And I don't see anything out of the ordinary there, but you never know until you go in, check your footage. And we are on the tracking mount, so. Let's try to get it in frame here. There we go. So the other camera's still recording. And we might put a video on top of a video here. Probably put it in the corner. So it's good to try out new equipment and the old, even though it's quite nippy out here. So I'm gonna wish you all a great new week ahead. Take care and please be safe. Bye from Ohio. It's now 6:45 p.m. up here. Bye now. Anyway, that'll do it. Tote all this equipment in now. Oh, joy.